Hey, what's up, guys? John here. I cannot believe what is happening right now in Florida. The Florida real estate market, we see prices going through the roof. That's going to change. It's going to change in a very, very big way. And it's not the affordability crisis, which a lot of weight has been pushed on this, saying that people can't afford these rents, they can't afford these prices. What I think it's going to be is going to be this insurance problem. Over 150,000 policies canceled. They're not renewing. And they're saying they're not doing this because of increased risk. Now, we take a look at how insurance, how they factor out their risk. They're looking at replacement costs. They're looking at the likelihood of damage. They're looking at what it would actually cost them to service that policy to drum up a profit. Well, now costs are increasing through the board. Everything is getting so much more expensive. We see it. We see what inflation is. You go to Home Depot, you buy a box of screws or a piece of, you know, plywood. You buy something at Home Depot, you see how much you're paying today versus how much you were paying 6 months ago, a year ago, 2 years ago. Insurance companies are seeing the same thing, right? But what they're doing now is they're just saying, you know what, screw it. We're just canceling. We're not going to take on this risk because we can't make money here. So they're canceling 150,000 policies canceled in last year. I think that's only going to continue to get worse and worse and worse. Now, what I think is unique, is very fascinating, is what's happened over the last 2 years. So much money, so many wealthy people and entrepreneurs and successful, you know, business people from all over the country, but mainly New York and California, where they're accustomed to paying $3,000 a month, $4,000 a month, no problem for an apartment, coming to Florida, saying, hey, $3,000, $4,000, I can go buy a $850,000 house or $1 million house, put down $100,000, $150,000, $200,000, and I'm in it. And I got this beautiful house. And, you know, before I was just in this tiny apartment in downtown LA, now I have this 4-bedroom house right next to, you know, Main Street near the water. I have all these amenities, right? And so everyone was flooding here, but they bought in thinking that they were buying into a piece of freedom. They were going to be able to have a lifestyle that they wanted. They were going to have everything, no income tax. It was going to be the perfect scenario. But now what is happening is that not only are costs increasing in their everyday lives, but so is the cost for facilitating that mortgage. And most people don't think about this. Most people say, hey, I got a 30-year fixed rate. My payment's $3,500 a month. You know, I make $10,000 or $12,000 a month. It's not a problem. I can afford it. Some people run out there and they'll say, yeah, let's go ahead and do it. But then insurance costs picking up dramatically every single year. And if you have a mortgage on that property, that lender is going to demand that you have insurance. And so the insurance essentially can dictate the valuations of these properties. Because if they say, hey, you know, in insurance, the only rate you can get is going from $10,000 a year to $20,000 a year. If you have a mortgage, you're gonna have to pay it. And if you can't pay it, you're gonna have to either lease out the home or sell the property. I talked about this a while ago, saying, hey, look at what the CEO of Redfin's saying. I'm gonna show you this article. CEO of Redfin, he simply said, I think the idea that climate change is going to be factored into how people think about housing, it hasn't happened yet. The only people who have figured out, the actuaries, insurance companies, mortgage lenders, people who have to calculate the cost of insuring these properties, said Kelman, who has led Redfin for the last 15 years. Increasingly, it's gonna get harder to get insurance. It's gonna be harder to get a loan for these properties because the lenders are gonna see the writing on the wall that this is collateral risk. Now, what he's saying, the only thing I'm really looking at here is that he's letting everybody know that, and this is what they do, they'll let you know ahead of time. They're letting everyone know that insurance is gonna go up, problems are gonna come, and this article was in, published September 3rd of 2021. Now, posted it September 3rd of 2021, and right after that, everything started snowballing, but things have just been getting progressively worse. And what also happens when you step into an economic environment like we're in now with stocks plummeting, cryptos plummeting, everything's happening, scams. That's exactly what happens. People say, hey, my house caught on fire, or I need a new roof, or I need this, and they'll actually, I was reading this article here, it's pretty fascinating what they do. Here's what's going on with skyrocketing homeowners insurance costs in Florida and five things you can do to lower your bill. The insurance market has become increasingly volatile in the U.S. In the recent past, resulting in inflated premiums across all insurance products. In the past few years, natural disasters and political unrest have decreased the risk appetite among providers throughout the U.S., causing rising rates, said Ken Gregg, CEO of Orion 180, a homeowners insurance providing services to independent agents of Southeast U.S. Florida in particular is seeing some of the highest homeowner insurance rate hikes and the largest number of policy non-renewals in the nation. According to data from the S&P Global Market Intelligence, by mid-April, Florida's residential insurance market will see a cancellation of approximately 37,000. I guess that's in addition to the 150,000 that were just canceled. So you're talking 190,000 policies canceled. And you have a little over 9 million overall dwellings in Florida. That's including apartments, right? So this is a substantial problem. And Florida is experiencing the worst property insurance crisis in the U.S. according to data from the S&P Global 500. By the end of 2021, Florida's residential insurance providers experienced a net income loss of $1 billion. Many providers are leaving the state, and larger insurers like Geico and Progressive are canceling policies among homeowners in the region. Greg cites a few reasons for this occurrence: forthcoming weather-related risk, insurance scams, or frivolous lawsuits. Florida is home to regular floods and hurricane disasters. Insurers are prepping for considerable water, wind, and flood damage claims, and as a result, loss of profitability. Hurricane season in Florida begins June 1, according to Florida's Division of Emergency Management. Another reason Florida homeowners are seeing an increase in their premiums due to insurance scam, Greg says, the increase in claims is driven by bad faith actors in contracting and litigating markets. One of the main scams involves a bad faith roofing contract. Contractors solicit you, the homeowner, to pay for a new roof with your insurance, claiming that they can offer you a rebate for your deductible. The scammer will have you sign an agreement allowing them to file a claim with your insurance provider. An adjuster will then visit your property, inspect the damage, the reason that the claim was made, and upon finding little to no damage, your insurance provider company will refuse to provide compensation. The dishonest home contractor will then sue your provider for insufficient payouts, and the insurance will either have to undergo court proceedings or settle the compensation out of court. Now, the cost to put a new roof on, depending on the size of the house, might be 15, 18 grand for like a very, very, very tiny house. Could go all the way up to $50,000, $100,000, depending on the size, right? And the material costs are only going up, so that number will likely continue to change. But what we are going to see here is that if they were to go take that to court, their legal fees alone would probably be 2x that. They might spend $150,000 just taking it to court, $200,000 just taking it to court. And so because of that, they're like, you know what, forget it. We might not even win. And even if we do win, we still lose. It's better just to write the check for $50,000, right? And then the contractor's like, hey, I'll do it for $45,000 or I'll do it for $40,000. The contractor takes $40,000, the homeowner takes $10,000, right? And as this happens, what happens? Greg explains that the roof isn't free for two reasons. One, your premiums will rise because you filed a claim for a new roof. And two, everyone buying insurance will also effectively have to pay for that new roof. As a result, the aggregate cost of premium increases for policyholders due to a growing number of insurance scams and property lawsuits in Florida. Insurers are seeing tremendous losses in net income. Well, how much is it now? In 2019, the average homeowner insurance premium was $1,989. In the U.S., according to the Insurance Information Institute, the average cost of premiums in Florida in 2022 was $35.85, approximately a 55% rate hike in the last 3 years. 55% rate hike in the last 3 years. And don't forget a FEMA's 2.0 rating that just came out maybe 6-8 months ago, which was laying out a map of where all insurance costs are going, and Florida is not looking good. Granted, homeowners across the nation are seeing a premium increase, but not quite as much as Florida. Florida's premiums are $2,187 more than the national average. Below are rates for a few of the cheapest homeowner insurance options in Florida. This is what's going to happen. We're going to have more and more of these insurance scams as people start running into financial deficits, people start losing a lot of money. We're gonna have a lot of people that simply get priced out of their home because of what's happening with insurance. And we're gonna have a lot of the appeal that brought people to Florida take them out of Florida. I think we're gonna see a massive pullback in the Florida real estate market. I think there could be some very, very big opportunities for cash buyers coming very, very soon. I think as we step forward the next 6 months, a year, 18 months, we're gonna really start to see major, major headwind and major concern across the eyes of homeowners throughout the state of Florida, and big opportunities will follow for real estate investors. What do you think about this entire situation? Where do you see insurance costs going in Florida? Drop your comments below. Hit the like button. When you hit the like button, YouTube's gonna share this content to educate more people about what's going on in the real estate market. Subscribe here. Also, my second YouTube channel. It's going to be a podcast, and it's also going to be a really interactive, cool show where I'm going to take calls. People are going to be able to call in, present real estate deals, talk about money, credit, business, the economy. It's going to be a one-on-one, really interactive experience. It's going to be really cool. Looking forward to that. And then also TikTok, LinkedIn, Instagram, everything's in the banner. I'll catch you guys later.